Welcome inside the National Indoor Stadium in Beijing, China. It is the final day of the Paralympic Winter Games. It's the 16th and final game. It's the gold medal game. USA, the three-time reigning Paralympic champions against their North American rivals, Canada. These two teams met for gold at the last Paralympic Winter Games. In fact, they met for gold at the last five World Championship Games. The USA has the edge. Today, Canada will try to knock the Americans off their Paralympic pedestal. Both teams have shown brilliance in the tournament. Both have romped to massive semifinal wins. But we cannot forget that back on day one, USA beat Canada convincingly. Can they do it again? Or will the men of the Maple Leaf find a weakness in the mighty American armor?
Well, both sides winning their semifinals by identical 11-0 score lines. The Americans defeating the previously impressive Chinese, the Canadians romping over the South Korean team. Canada has a lot of mental baggage to overcome in this game today. Some close losses and a very big loss in the World Championship final last year, in which they had only one shot on goal against the USA, a 5-1 defeat. I think the Americans have to be strongly favored in this game, but by no means prohibitively so. The Canadians are feeling good. The camp is loose. They feel like they're playing their best hockey. The Americans as well feel pretty much the same way. So a little bit of puck luck might determine the outcome of this game. If the puck bounces your way, get an opening goal for Canada, maybe that could loosen things up. But certainly the Americans will feel that they are in the box seat for the gold medal here today.
Canada bringing 10 Paralympic medalists into this game. USA has 11 Paralympic medalists. Jacob Grumsen from Sweden, from Denmark, is the referee in this one.
There you see the American team sheet. Declan Farmer will almost certainly win the scoring title in the competition. In only three games, he has 5 goals and 10 assists at 17 points at the Paralympics 4 years ago to lead the scoring charge then as well. Brody Roybal has been very impressive. He had 4 goals and 2 assists against the Chinese. And up and down the USA depth chart, David Hoff has excellent players to turn to. That is really the secret of the American success in this tournament and in previous competitions. As for the Canadian side, Dominic Larocque, he had 17 saves on 21 American shots in the group stage game between these sides. Tyler McGregor came to life in the 11-0 win against the Koreans with 4 goals and 2 assists. Billy Bridges had a hat trick. He has 28 career Paralympic goals in his 6th Paralympic Winter Games. Such experience for him, and up and down Ken Babby's roster, but they just feel maybe a little bit step or two behind coming into this game. But over the course of 45 minutes, anything can and very possibly will happen.
Last year at the World Championships, it was Canada winning in the round robin, USA winning when it mattered most in the gold medal game. They met last fall in St. Louis, Missouri. They split a 2-game series. Canada won the opening game. The U.S. won the second game. So this really could be tight. Canada took a penalty early on in the first game of the tournament. USA scored on the power play and never really looked back. By the way, the mentioned the referee, Jacob Grumsen, Andreas Lunden from Sweden, and Jan Vanek from the Czech Republic are the linesmen, linespersons.
And so much depends on early shifts in this game. Can the Canadians get out on the front foot? You feel like the Americans can absorb an early Canadian goal, maybe better than the reverse would be the case. Canada has to get off to a positive start in this game if they want to really test the Americans and keep in this game for all 45 minutes, I feel.
Billy Bridges will be on this faceoff for Team Canada, number 3 in tournament scoring, faceoffs that is, at 64%. And we're underway in the gold medal game in para ice hockey here in Beijing. And the USA in blue with the puck. Centering pass ends up on the stick of Ben Delaney. It's Canada in white, USA in blue. Delaney slides it ahead for James Dunn. He had a hat trick earlier in the tournament in the first game against Korea. Here's Wallace. Super solid Jack Wallace on the blue line. But here comes Brody Roybal. His shot wide of the net, but not by much, where Dominic Larocque is tending that net. Liam Hickey has been switched partway through this tournament from forward to defense. He was top defenseman at the last two World Championships. He's in number 23 for Canada. Here's Roybal with a shot. It's blocked. And Hickey will slide it ahead for Delaney. He's got Bridges moving. He doesn't see him. Now he does. And he'll just touch it into the zone and head off in a line change.
Clever play from Bridges, making sure there would be no icing there against the Canadians.
Lavin takes a hit, but got the puck ahead. Now Armstrong will try to keep it in for Canada. He does send it back in. They clear the zone. We're just over a minute into this gold medal game. Noah Grove playing in his first gold medal game. He's playing in his second, but USA does have several players playing in their first. So does Canada. And it is Declan Farmer now racing out to center ice. Farmer just a dynamic player and leading the tournament in scoring. And the play just inside the Canadian blue line. It ends up in the corner. Armstrong goes after it. Watched by Misevich. Armstrong slams Misevich, or at least Zeich, into the end boards. And it is covered up by Dominic Larocque on the early whistle. A minute 49 gone by in this opening period. No shots on net yet.
But the pace of play already electric. Both sides zooming up and down the ice. I suspect even a faster pace of play than in the group game between these two teams. This is the game that all these players live for. They've all talked about it following their semifinal wins. And it's just an honor to be on the ice in this building. Gold medal game. It's best you can ask for in para ice hockey, really.
Adam Dixon back in his own corner. Took a bit of time off. Said it took a lot longer and a lot more effort to come back to the same level as he was before, and he says he's not sure he's even there yet. Here's Wallace, and his centering pass deflects to the corner. It'll be Zeich who gets to it, along with Dixon, who spun around. Now Wallace in front of the net, trying to feed Misevich. It just rolled off his stick, and the Canadians bank it out to center. Grabbed by Wallace. He has been so impressive in this tournament. He launches it into the Canadian end. Liam Hickey goes back for it. The pride of St. John's, Newfoundland. Ahead for Delaney, ahead for Bridges. He is hounded by Farmer. They both go down. The puck springs free and it's dumped in by the Canadians. Tyler McGregor, Canada's captain, is after it. He is slammed against the boards by Declan Farmer. The puck squirts free and Malik Jones will come up with it, playing in his first Paralympic gold medal game. And Zach Lavin. It's stolen by the U.S. and then stolen right back by Canada. Tyrone Henry brings it in, swings a pass in for Westlake. He snaps a shot, didn't get much on it with the left hand. Westlake playing in his fifth Paralympic games. He's one of two players on Canada that have won Paralympic gold, along with Billy Bridges, as Brody Roybal collects the puck. Surveys the scene and almost coughed it up, but racing back for it is Grove around the boards, kept in by the team in white, Canada, Armstrong. Now it's flipped to the blue line. He makes another play to keep it in. And after it goes Westlake, but Josh Paul's smooth play to give it back to Eustace. Drops it back there for Grove, out to center ice, and here come the Americans. Malik Jones racing back as Armstrong, and he just cuts him off. Here's Jones again. Steals the puck, looks out front, and his pass doesn't connect. And then Henry leans on Jones and sends it out to center.
Americans making a few nervous-looking mistakes in that shift. Allowed a two-on-one chance, which was denied, and then the bad giveaway in their own defensive zone. So that may be a little bit of a positive sign for the Canadians.
And an icing call against the U.S. and a fast-paced opening period yet to record our first shot on either Dominic Larocque or Jen Lee. Lee has not allowed a goal the entire tournament.
There's that two-on-one I was talking about. Fired well wide of the net. That left-handed shot of Westlake. Loads of Canadian social media interest in this game, by the way. NHL star Connor McDavid, a lot of the Canadian women's gold medal players from the Olympics a few weeks ago here in the Wukasong Sports Center, the other of the two hockey arenas that were used for the Olympics.
Liam Hickey goes back to retrieve it, leaves it there for Dixon. The top defense pairing for Canada gives up the puck. Declan Farmer try to work it in. There's a shot. Larocque the save. And our first shot results in a nice save by Larocque and holding on to it.
And that's the kind of pattern of play the Americans want to see. Farmer in a good shooting position, but also the swarming players around the net of Dominic Larocque.
No score, early stages, USA-Canada here at the National Indoor Stadium.
Here's what I'm talking about. You see Josh Misevich cutting in front of the goaltender Dominic Larocque, trying to set a little bit of a screen. Also, Kyle Zeick flinging his body around, almost generating a little bit of space for Farmer to take the shot. Slightly surprising, they only get the first shot of the game 4.5 minutes in. But that's a real sign of how tightly contested we feel this game is going to be. You don't feel like the Canadians can win decisively over the Americans. If they're going to win, it's going to be a close, tight contest. The Americans are the ones who want to get on the board, want to strut their stuff, show their superiority in the early stages, and just carry that right through the full 45 minutes. But Canada giving as good as they have been getting thus far in the first 4.5 minutes.
No score in the gold medal game. Early stages, opening period. It'll be Declan Farmer against Greg Westlake on the faceoff. Farmer wins it, hustles to it along the boards, spins away from the checks into the area behind the net for Misevich, gives it back to Farmer, got a shot, missed on the short side, and it'll go down the ice. Of course, no icing. It was sent down by the U.S. As we approach the 5-minute mark of the opening period, Jack Wallace from Franklin Lakes, New Jersey, gives it to Declan Farmer. From Tampa Bay, Florida, across the center line, across the blue line, still going, Farmer, and he's spun around and hit by Hickey, and that was looking so dangerous. Sent down the ice by Canada, right on Jen Lee's net. That should be Canada's first recorded shot, as the Americans pick up the puck with Brody Roybal. Spins away from Bridges, who got just enough of him to slow him down, but here comes Wallace jumping on the rush. Will he get any help? Not yet. Buys a little time, sends it across. His teammates were changing, and it's picked up by Malik Jones. Stick handling through center. This is going to be offside at the Team Canada blue line. 9:17 to go, opening period. No score, USA and Canada.
If you're not familiar with the rules of ice hockey or para ice hockey, the player in possession of the puck has to be the first one over the blue line of the opposing team. That time, the American skater was ahead of the puck. That's why the faceoff draw coming out to center ice. All of these sled blades on the bottom of the sleds are so sharp, the players will sharpen them off in between periods. Really have to keep as tight an edge as possible to maintain maximum maneuverability.
Tyrone Henry banks the puck off the boards, just out of the reach of Billy Bridges. Josh Pauls goes back to get it. Bridges and Pauls have known each other and played against each other for well over a decade. And here comes USA. Brody Roybal chasing after it, but hustling to get there was Armstrong, just enough on it to clear it out of harm's way. Delaney is run over by Malik Jones. On a clean check, Eustace goes after it in the corner. Got it to Jones. Hounded by Delaney and Bridges. Canada gets it ahead, not out yet. They'll try again. Comes to the blue line and swatted right back in again by Brody Roybal. Roybal had 4 goals in the semifinal, along with 2 assists against China. A lot of people thought the team from China was gonna threaten the U.S. in some way, but it really never materialized. It was 11-0 when all was said and done. Here's James Dunn, shovels the puck to center. Delaney races for it, but already getting there was Brody Roybal.
Yeah, the speed difference between the B-level teams that the Chinese were playing and these two sides here, so noticeable.
Canada getting its third line on the ice. Here's Liam Hickey, the defenseman, jumping in on the rush. Launches a left-hand shot that didn't miss by a whole lot. Anton Jacobs-Webb digging for it along the boards. USA will get it to center ice where Adam Dixon's waiting.
A shot from Hickey. Jen Lee was leaning the wrong way. If it had been on target, that could have been the first goal.
They didn't actually record that earlier shot. I guess it came from the Canadian side of center. Here's Hickey with a shot. Lee the save.
That'll be a shot on goal, certainly.
Under 7.5 minutes to go. So we're halfway through the opening period. No score. This is longer than Canada kept the U.S. off the board in the preliminary round.
Big hit. Wallace knocking McGregor to the deck.
Liam Hickey goes back to get it. And he's just drawn a penalty. And so it's going to be Canada to the power play when USA touches the puck. And here's a chance instead. Busting in is Hickey. He's all by himself. Liam Hickey shoots. Rolls. Stopped by Lee. And he'll keep it out of the net with the help of his teammates, as Hickey might have fanned on it. But Canada is going to get a power play.
Unbelievable stop from Lee to keep the game scoreless. It was the penalty to Adam Dixon that led to the first American goal in the group stage game between these sides. Josh Paul's getting it, but the Canadians, with the penalty committed by Wallace, seeing is the call. When you lead with the front of your sled and you make a ramming sort of contact with your opponent, here's the chance. Lee, it was whipped upon. Lee still had to reach back to make the stop. Sometimes you almost see the puck dummied into the net like that, but Lee able to get the mitt down on the ice as Wallace sits in the American sin bin.
He does indeed. We do have a bit of a delay. Not sure what it's all about.
There's some net repairs being made after the collision with Lee knocked backwards into his cage. So we'll have to get the maintenance crew out on the ice, and that will give the American penalty killers and the Canadian power play units time to fully rest up. Canada only 2-for-6 on the power play in the tournament. Of course, both of these teams have only played 3 games thanks to the abbreviated Group A schedule after the exclusion of the Russian Paralympic Committee from the tournament. The Americans have killed off all 5 of the penalties that they have committed in terms of shorthanded action. So that's after the Americans actually had the second worst penalty kill at the World Championships last year. They allowed 3 goals on 11 attempts. They've tightened things up in the little action we've seen from them, but the Canadians only got 1 power play chance against the USA on opening day of the tournament, so this could be a real chance for them to spring in front as we approach the later stages of the first period.
So Liam Hickey kind of started and almost finished that play. He first draws the penalty, and then he jumps in on the offense, and it almost went in. It almost looked like he was doing what we call the old Forsberg move, where you go left and leave the puck right, but he kind of fanned on it. Canada on the power play, 33% in the tournament. Here's McGregor, the captain, with a shot that never got through. Josh Pauls, it's under McGregor, I think, or is it in the gear of Pauls? Not sure, but it is blown down, and it's a case of the disappearing puck again. We've had this before in the tournament.
Indeed, into Pauls' paraphernalia, you might say.
That's awesome.
Pauls with the shot block. You see the American penalty killers are not going to remain passive. They're going to test the shooters and full rush fully out into them. You see, there's the puck. Wow.
Declan Farmer getting his stick to help out.
That's something.
Well, it's kind of like in basketball. You see, every once in a while, when someone shoots it from a certain angle on the side, it gets caught on the rim and the backboard. But I've never seen this caught at this length before. Finally, free.
A little high comedy at the start of a very important moment in this first period.
Well, you'd say that Josh Pauls, the puck is attracted to him like a magnet. Team Canada on the power play. It's McGregor. Little drop off for Bridges, and he pounds one wide of the net. Hickey at the point. Canada essentially 5 forwards on this power play unit. Hickey transferred from defense to forward. Here's McGregor, swings a pass across. Can Bridges get there? No, but he'll have to hustle out to center. And he's watched by Farmer. Gives the pass to Liam Hickey. Hickey's played wheelchair basketball at the Paralympic Summer Games. And these are his 3rd games overall. Here is Bridges with the puck. And he has it stolen. This is going to be a chance for Declan Farmer racing in. He's got Pauls with him. Farmer. And he shoots and scores. Shorthanded goal. Declan Farmer. USA draws first blood.
The opening power play of the game did prove to be incredibly important, but in the opposite direction that we could have imagined. That was a kind bounce for Farmer, but it was caused by his aggressiveness on the perimeter. He was trying to impede the play, got the puck onto the shaft of his stick, pushed it forward, and he was off to the races. He had Pauls in front. That was actually the combination for the first goal of the group stage game between these teams. But instead, Larocque maybe playing the pass, Farmer the perfect shot, and the Americans getting that early goal they desperately wanted.
Declan Farmer's impressive tournament continues. His sixth goal now. Check that, his seventh goal. So Declan Farmer, an unassisted goal. Canada still on the power play. So I was right the first time. It is his sixth goal of the tournament.
And this is the opportunity. Oh, my goodness, look at this.
Here's Rybas! Scores! Another shorthanded goal, and it's a disaster for Canada. They might have wanted to decline that first power play.
Oh, my goodness. Brody Roybal, opportunistic forechecking on the penalty kill. He got deep into the Canadian zone. He's just trying to disrupt the Canadians from bringing the puck out of their zone. He got more than he could have ever bargained for there. And the look on the face of Dominic Larocque behind the mask, just trying to clear the puck up. And that was very straightforward for Roybal. His seventh goal in the tournament, with four goals against China in the semifinals. And the Canadians have already taken their 162nd timeout in the game, trying to recover from the disaster of giving up two shorthanded goals in the same Canadian power play.
Dominic Larocque, who is considered one of the top goaltenders in this sport. And that time, as you kind of alluded to, he has no one to blame but himself with the giveaway. He's trying to make the good play, trying to get his team heading on offense to get the tying goal.
That's probably born out of the first shorthanded goal. He wants to make something happen. He wants to see the Canadians get back and score an equalizing goal on the power play, but his eyes may be too big for his stomach there, Dominic Larocque, who used to be not a goalie, used to be a skater before switching after the Sochi tournament 8 years ago at the Paralympics, and maybe trying to play the way that he used to play the puck. And problem is, when you're the last line of defense, you make a giveaway like that, it's so easy for the open goal there for Roybal.
25 seconds between the two shorthanded goals for USA. Canada is still on the power play for about 35 seconds now as Westlake battles with Farmer. Hickey comes in to throw the hit, and it comes back to Larocque. This time he flips it up the left side. Dunn tips it ahead for Bridges. Tries to shovel it in for Hickey, who runs over the American player Pauls. And Canada on offense, but it's going to be offside as Dunn kind of put himself offside. You've got to go in after the puck, and he kind of went in before the puck. And in meaning past the blue line if you're new to hockey.
For what it's worth, China in their first two Group B games against Slovakia and the Czech Republic, they had two shorthanded goals in each of those two games, but they never managed it twice on the same power play chance of their opponents. And my goodness, Farmer and Roybal, the two stars of this American team, shining brightly already in this gold medal game.
Adam Dixon's going to go back to pick up the puck in his own zone. Dixon, a couple of medals on his resume, a silver and a bronze. Westlake has a gold as well, and as he sends it ahead to Hickey, who tips it into the zone and then kind of lost track of it. Back it comes to center ice, hops over the stick of Misevich. Dixon goes after it. Shots on goal are 3-3. However, the score, 2-0 USA. Teams are back to full and even strength as Liam Hickey takes the puck and gets out of trouble in his own end. He's being hounded by Farmer. That gives you a sense of how fast Hickey is as he works around a man and another, gets the left-hand shot, and Jen Lee looks into his glove and says, look what I found, as he makes the save and holds on.
That was a nifty little glove stop there by Lee.
2-0, USA leads, 4:15 to go in the opening period.
Can Canadians trying their best to rush forward. That was a very difficult stop to hold on to the puck for Lee, turning his glove sort of on the backhand side, and it's right below your eye level. It's very difficult to see the puck as you move your glove in front of your face like that. But Lee taking over for the great Steve Cash in goal for the American team. Cash retired quite suddenly back in October after 16 years as the number one American goaltender in para ice hockey. But you can see that although Lee hasn't really been tested in the tournament, his defense has been so good in front of him. When he is called upon, he's able to make the save, give no rebound up. And I'll tell you what, from front to back, this American team is so, so good. Is it the best para ice hockey team ever, one wonders?
Face off in the USA zone. Up by two, a couple of shorthanded goals. Now back to even strength as Adam Dickson heads back to pick up the puck. Expect he and Hickey to play a ton of minutes here in this game. Here is Hickey. Jones got just enough of it to knock it away. Hickey manages to get it into the zone. Roybal goes back for it. Brody Roybal's got away from Westlake. Sent up the boards for Hickey to stop it, actually, for the Canadians. Jones trying to get it out. The scramble produces a loose puck that's sent towards the net by Hickey. Another penalty coming here against the U.S. as McGregor was upended in front. It's going to be an interference call.
I think it's on Joseph Woodkey, former United States Marine Corps service member for the USA. He's been sent to the sin bin. He got a little bit over anxious in the slot, the area between the two faceoff rings. Watch the collision right there. You can make that sort of contact when a player has the puck in his possession, but it was nowhere near McGregor and the Canadians. Well, second power play, they have to hope it goes better than the first one in this first period.
They win the faceoff. Here's McGregor, drops it off for Bridges. Absorbs a hit, ties up his man long enough to allow McGregor to grab the puck, snaps one wide of the net. And back to his own zone to pick it up is Liam Hickey. Continues to look over his shoulder, surveying where Declan Farmer is. Hickey holds it deep in the corner, slides it ahead for Billy Bridges. Playing the sixth Paralympic Games. Across the blue line, drops it off there for McGregor. He tips it ahead for Westlake, in front for Dunn, and he tips it over top of the net. Nicely constructed chance there for Canada. They couldn't quite finish.
Yeah, the best passing maneuver of the game so far. Dunn streaking to the net. He got Wood on the puck trying to tip it home, but just flipped it high in the end.
Bridges to the blue line. Now for McGregor. Works it ahead for Armstrong with a shot. Dunn the save, or at least Jen Lee the save. Here's McGregor's shot. That's blocked. And it comes to Wallace, and he's going to send it down the ice. Less than a minute to go in the USA penalty.
And the coolness of Wallace in the penalty kill. He just swiveled right around top of the faceoff rings. Canadians were near to him, but it didn't look like it from how easily he was able to clear.
Armstrong heads back into his own corner to pick up the puck. Rob Armstrong, second Paralympic Games. He was on the team that won the World Championships in 2017 and came so close to an empty net goal that would have given Canada the win in Pyeongchang, but he probably wants to forget about that. And erased that today. Here is Zach Lavin as he comes in to scoop up the puck across the ice for Hickey. Comes outside the blue line, so they have to backtrack. Hickey stick handling, got it ahead for Lavin. Jams on the brakes, still has the puck, swings it to the net. Here is Riley going after it. Now Delaney, Americans all collapse in front of the goaltender, and Canada comes out with Riley. Teams are back to full strength. Here's Hickey. Back to the blue line for Dixon. Stick handles, left stick to right across the ice. There's Hickey with a shot. Rebound loose, jam away in front. Puck is still loose, but it is not seen by the official, and he didn't like all the traffic, so he blows it down.
No goal there for the Canadians on the power play, but some very promising signs. They only had 9 shots on goal in the entirety of the group stage game between these teams. They have 7 already. Look at this wild flurry. Lee making the save, pushing the puck into danger, but this time the Americans swarming back defensively. Woodkey back on the ice, able to eventually clear the puck, although after the whistle had blown.
Canadians with a bit of a different look. They've got McGregor kind of lurking off behind the play. If they can swing him the puck, you send it into the corner. After it goes Wallace. He is watched by McGregor, the two number eights. Dug free by Woodke. Americans to center ice, where Westlake is waiting. He'll drop it off for Dunn, swats it back to the USA blue line. And James Dunn tries to get it ahead for his teammate McGregor. Can't on the first try. Westlake will help out. Less than 45 seconds to go in the opening period. Liam Hickey to center. Now across the blue line. Brings it in on the wing. In front for McGregor, and he snaps one high and over top of the net. Dunn in for McGregor, but it's intercepted smartly by Wallace, but then kept in at the blue line smartly by Dixon. He'll swing a pass in for Westlake. On net, caught by Lee. He'll hold on. 17.1 seconds left in the period.
I'm beginning to sense that the Canadians' best chance of getting real difficult shots on target will involve the overly aggressive American defense. They're sending bodies out to the point, the area just inside the American blue line, and sometimes when they fail to get possession of the puck, that leaves an overbalance for Canadian players between them and Jen Lee's nets. Thus far, they haven't given up that first goal, but that could be the route home for Canada in the second and third periods.
Farmer won that key faceoff against Bridges, but so far the Americans can't get it out of the zone. They've only got a few seconds to kill off. Here is Declan Farmer in his own corner, banks it on the boards to center. Dixon's going to shoot it back in, and the horn will sound. It was a span of 25 seconds, shorthanded, that Jen Lee's Team USA scored twice on Dominic Larocque, and they lead it 2-0 in the gold medal game after one period of play here at the National Indoor Stadium in Beijing, China.
Dominic Larocque, the best goaltender at the last two World Championship tournaments. He has to be feeling sick to his stomach after the giveaway, which led to that second goal, the one scored by Brody Roybal. The Americans outshot 8-3 in the first period. No one saw that coming, but two of those three American shots into the net, and that is why they lead at the end of 15 minutes by the score of 2-0.
Really fast-paced opening period that saw both teams go end-to-end. USA capitalizing on a couple of mistakes by the Canadian power play unit and one by the goaltender. And they scored twice, despite getting outshot 8-3. 2-0 the score after one period of play. Canada 0-2 on its power play, and you know the rest of the story, giving up the two shorthanded goals.
First period highlights the gold medal game in the para ice hockey tournament at Beijing 2022. Good physical battles in the early going. Fast, firm skating up the ice for both teams as well. Canadians seem to get on the front foot. The shot there just wide from Greg Westlake. They had more territorial possession than we might have expected in the first period, although Dominic Larocque was tested there by the buzzing Declan Farmer. More from him in a moment. Canadians, there you see Farmer with the screen set in front by Josh Misevich, but Larocque spotting the puck and covering it up nicely. Americans, though, watch Declan Farmer coming up through center ice, splitting the defense and just getting spun around before able to release the shot. Good Canadian defense, and the chance in front, that was penetration by Liam Hickey, but the net knocked off its moorings. He wasn't able to release the shot, really. Jen Lee getting the glove down just in time. Stopped that puck from trickling behind himself into the net. the Canadians firing the shot wide, but then the key break forward, shorthanded Declan Farmer going it alone. He had Brody, Josh Pauls to possibly pass to, but Farmer beat LaRock. And the Americans, despite being 4-on-5, took the lead in this game, 1-0. And then disaster for Dominic LaRock, gave the puck straight away to Brody Roybal. Roybal making no mistake, his tournament leading 7th goal of the competition, 25 seconds after the previous goal. Jen Lee at the other end, a nice glove save there, showing his poise in the American goal. Canadians got some pressure onto the American net late on in the period, but Lee, his net still undented. Canadians huffing and puffing. Another late power play chance, but Lee able to poke the puck away with his blocker on that effort from Garrett Riley. And so after one period of play, the Americans perhaps 1/3 of the way to another Paralympic gold medal. They lead Canada by 2-0.
Second period of the gold medal game is upon us at the National Indoor Stadium in Beijing, China. Final medal event for the Paralympic Winter Games. USA scoring twice in that opening period on goals by Declan Farmer, shorthanded at 9:08, and then Brody Roybal shorthanded 25 seconds later at 9:33. Bit of a disastrous start for the team in white. They seem to rebound after that, played well to end the period, but still trail 2-0 after one period of play.
And this a real occasion of the entire Paralympic Winter Games. Quite a decent crowd given the COVID-related restrictions that we are seeing in Beijing throughout the Olympic and Paralympic Games, and loads of athletes in the building as well. So many members of the other teams in this tournament gathering around. We saw the Slovakian side finish seventh in the competition before the game, and the concourse sort of roaming around, and so many people in wheelchairs have pulled up around the perimeter of the stadium. And the sport is going from strength to strength. The importance of this game is increasing in the entire para sport movement. The ice hockey players, all of whom just love this sport and will be the best evangelists you can possibly have. Many of them have come to para ice hockey from different para sports, from summer and winter games, and all of them, I mean, these two teams clearly the pinnacle of the sport right now. And the Americans not having it their own way by any sense in that first period. Outshot 8-3. The Canadians had more of the chances, in part because they had the two power plays. The Americans have not taken advantage of a 5-on-4 just yet. But if, as you say, if the Canadians can manage to mentally rid themselves of the baggage of those two shorthanded goals, every chance that they are still right in this. But they must believe. They must not lose heart. And the Americans, well, they have to make a few mistakes still, because even when they overcommit up top with the Canadians on the attack, they still have the strong defense, and they still have that man, Brody Roybal, a goal-scoring sensation now with 17 career Paralympic ice hockey goals in this, only his third Paralympic tournament.
In their history, these two teams have met 106 times before. Canada has the edge, 56-49, and then one tie. But obviously, in the biggest games at the Paralympic Winter Games, when the gold was on the line, USA has the edge. However, they have played three different teams on their way to gold. This will be the only time they have a repeat of the same team they face. USA beat Japan in 2010, Russia in 2014, and Canada in 2018. You don't see that very often. Greg Westlake thrown out of a faceoff to start the period. And now we're underway. Second period of the gold medal game. USA leading 2-0. One of the goal scorers is Brody Roybal. He's got it. Here he comes, looking for more. His shot off the shoulder of LaRock and goes up and out of play just 10 seconds into the period, exactly the way Canada did not want to start the period.
Roybal, the acceleration to get so quickly into the Canadian zone. Might just have been a blocker save by LaRock, and although that wasn't the start that the rest of the team would have wanted, LaRock actually getting the arm up in the way, that'll be a confidence-boosting save for him. He only made one save in the entirety of the first period, conceded two goals.
Liam Hickey is still on the ice for Canada. He played almost 11 minutes of the opening period, the opening 15-minute period. He's got it in behind his net, leaves it there for his partner, Adam Dixon, slides it into the corner for Ben Delaney. Comes to the blue line, kept in by USA, Roybal, but then Bridges had a stick on it, but now Eustace has it for the Americans, gives it to Malik Jones, in for Roybal, his shot, didn't get a whole lot on it, and rushing back was Hickey and Bridges, and one of them might have got a piece of it. As they push and shove in the corner, Delaney comes in, pushes it for Bridges, he'll chip it out to center, and Josh Pauls hustling back for it, being hounded by James Dunn. And Pauls just turns away from Dunn and will swing it ahead for Malik Jones. His left-hand pass finds Eustace, who's slammed into by Hickey. And the loose puck chopped out. Here's Pauls. He might have a path to the net. Here he goes, Josh Pauls. And coming back was Hickey, and he's taken a penalty. And this will be a penalty shot against the Canadian goaltender, as Hickey was ruled to have taken the feet out from Paul's. You be the judge.
Wow, it's a clear goal-scoring opportunity. He had the clear path to goal. Hickey came back, and that's why this isn't going to be a two-minute power play for the Americans. It's going to be a penalty shot. The puck put on the dot at center ice, and it looks like it's going to be the American captain looking to lead by example, Josh Paul's, to take this penalty shot.
They call him Spuds. Josh Paul's from Greenbrook, New Jersey. He's got two goals in the tournament. Here he comes, takes it on his right stick, brings it in on LaRocque. Stick handle, shoot, stop by LaRocque. And he seals the Canadian net to keep the score at 2-0.
Stony-faced Dominic LaRocque. He didn't bite for any of the stick handling maneuvers. He kept his weight perfectly distributed so he could go left or right as Paul's approached. A little shimmy, trying to reverse the puck behind LaRocque, but no sir. Big moment for Canada in this game.
Westlake and Farmer on the faceoff. Again, Westlake is thrown out. Zach Lavin will come in to take it. And a little confusion, but Lavin wants to go against Farmer's right hand. Finally does get that and wins the draw. Goes to Westlake. So obviously the Canadians have done some scouting, and they have a certain way they want to go against the opposition player. Here comes Westlake to center. Dumps it into the USA corner. After it goes McGregor, but getting there is Declan Farmer. He's got a goal already in the game. Looks out to center, slides a pass instead for Zeich. Gives it to Misevich. He'll loft it into the Canadian corner. Farmer racing to it. He's going to get there first. Declan Farmer spins away from trouble. Puck ends up in behind the Canadian icing line. And they scramble for it. Back to get it is Armstrong. Ahead for McGregor. And it comes out to center ice where it's scooped up by Noah Grove.
That American rush up the ice started with a sweet turn in his own corner by Declan Farmer. Such a maneuverable skater.
Tyrone Henry pushes it back to center. Noah Grove shoots it right back in again. Grove plays for the Boston Bruins sled team. A lot of affiliations with NHL clubs. Here come the Canadians to center. McGregor's got Bridges with him. Couldn't filter a pass, though, through. And quickly back down the ice is Roybal. He's dangerous. Here he comes. Roybal in. Shoots and scores. 3-0 USA. Brody Roybal's second of the game, his eighth of the tournament. And the U.S. is off and running.
Speed to burn for Roybal. Watch him at center ice. Maybe the bad decision there defensively from Tyrone Henry. He made it a little bit easy for Roybal to get in front, but once he was in that shooting position, Roybal knows exactly what to do. LaRocque kept the glove up, and Roybal went low. And is that maybe the moment when the USA will start to taste the gold medal in this final of the para ice hockey tournaments? Roybal unassisted, or beg your pardon, an assist to Joseph Woodkey at the 2:39 mark of this second period.
Canada wins the faceoff, needs to get something positive here. Delaney slides it into the corner. Here's Jones in behind his net. Slammed against the boards by Dunn. Delaney comes in to help out. Referee right there on the scene, Jacob Grumson from Denmark. Here's Dixon now, his shot blocked in front by Wallace. Wallace now spins to get it in the corner. Goes passing left stick to right, chips it ahead. Out of the reach of Eustace, he got it to Jones, but here's Billy Bridges. His pass is pushed ahead to Dunn. Racing into the play as Hickey gets the pass, tips it on net, and Jen Lee was ready for that tip. He didn't have much to do other than put the left stick on it, and he couldn't get a whole lot on the shot. Here's Wallace. Has it stripped by Bridges, who lost his stick, and it comes out to center ice. Dixon shovels it ahead. Now Delaney finds Bridges across the blue line. Left stick shot hard and high off of Lee. Stays in play. Here's Wallace. Off the boards to the blue line and out. Here's Hickey. Battling there with Eustace. Hickey from his belly slides it ahead to the line. Not at in, though. He's trying to do everything, Liam Hickey is. Puck comes to Lahou. Swings it across for Dixon. And the Canadian veteran gets it to the American line. And USA right back on offense. Here's Wallace across the blue line. Had it knocked away. Ends up in the corner. Farmer goes after it. But it's Liam Hickey who controls. Brody Roybal really slow to come back in the play. Something happened behind the play. Here is Farmer. His pass finds Josh Pauls. His shot is blocked. Scramble in front. Hickey got it ahead, but not out. Anton Jacobs-Webb to the line. Here's a long shot. Blocker saved by LaRocque. And Farmer is just everywhere. He goes and scoops up the puck again. Curls away from Riley. Swings it into the middle. Knocked away by the Canadians. Not out. Shot from the point by Noah Grove. Goes wide of the net. Here's Farmer. Centering pass goes right through the blue ice. Can the Americans keep it in? Yes, they do. Noah Grove with a nice play. Had it knocked away by Anton Jacobs-Webb, and the Canadians do get it out, and the Americans just loft it right back in.
Good work from Noah Grove in that shift defensively, just lurking outside the blue line.
Riley trying to chase down the puck in the USA zone, but Josh Paul's ever steady back there.
Americans always trying to keep at least one player back just in case they get a bad bounce. The Canadians start to rush forward. It was Groves on that shift, perfectly positioned to snuff out the Canadian threat of a counterattack quickly up the ice.
Now a steal for Westlake. Pushes it ahead for McGregor. See how much Canada decides to shorten its bench here. We haven't seen the third line a lot. They did just have a shift to maybe try to change the momentum a little bit. Liam Hickey is on the bench right now for a rare rest. Here is Westlake. Gives it to McGregor. Back to Westlake. Snaps a shot on net. Lee has it in his possession eventually. Took a bit, though. And with 8:40 to go in period number two, it is 3-0 USA over Canada in the gold medal game.
You talk about the Canadians shortening their bench. Ralph DeQuebec, who was such an impressive player against the Chinese team with his physical presence on the ice, hasn't had a shift yet in this game. Hasn't seen any ice time at all. You saw that good sprawling stop by Jen Lee and then the good work with LaRocque and his blocker. Both goaltenders regaining their composure. That time Lee, I think he knew that the puck was near him. He just had enough time to spot and cover. And Liam Hickey, one goal and four assists against the Koreans, but not quite happening for him yet in this contest. He has four shots on goal to lead the Canadian side, but how many of those shots have really been threatening? That's the difference, the quality of the American chances. Even though it's 10 shots apiece right now, the Americans with the three goals and more clear-cut chances to beat LaRocque even after the three goals they've scored.
Team Canada has its veterans. Billy Bridges on the ice, along with Adam Dixon, Liam Hickey, James Dunn, Ben Delaney. Americans go with Jack Wallace on defense. He's out there with Declan Farmer, Woodsky, Roybal, and Eustace. The 10 players on the ice here as they battle for gold. USA leading, two shorthanded goals in the first, another goal here. Here's Billy Bridges' shot that went off the side of the net. And it comes out to center ice. Dixon.
Bridges hadn't had to shoot at as well there from the sharp angle, but just fired it a tiny bit wide, rippling the net from the wrong side.
And so two shorthanded goals and one even strength goals. A goal has been the difference in this game. USA speed evident, and now it's on display again. Roybal, but Hickey getting back there. He's the one legitimate real speed threat for the Canadians. Here's a chance in front, and Farmer fires it. Not only over the net, but over the glass. Maybe a deflection, which would keep the faceoff in the Team Canada end.
Declan Farmer laughing. Not great. See the smile on the redheaded player's face. The giveaway, Farmer, he had the player coming in off the weak side. Josh Pauls could have dished it across, but not sure Farmer had a chance to see him as he was concentrating on the shot attempt. So close into Dominic Larocque, very difficult actually from so close in to find open space to shoot.
Kyle Zeick has the puck for USA. Slides it back into the corner. Jack Wallace, the defenseman, coming down low. Leaves it there for Misevich in behind the net. But Lavin takes it from him. And the Canadian forward sends it out to center, where it's scooped up by Anton Jacobs-Webb. Now it's sent into the USA zone. Farmer back for it, and he is hit by Lavin, who just let up enough, I think, at the end to avoid a penalty. Armstrong keeping the puck in, not for long. Here comes Declan Farmer, busting out to center, across the Canadian blue line. He's got Pauls with him. Feeds him the pass. Pauls shoots, scores! 4-0 USA, the dynamic duo again. Farmer to Pauls. Pauls finishes, and USA is really rolling now.
A mirror image of the goal that the Americans scored to open the contest in the group stage against Canada, and the opposite of the same rush that opened the scoring shorthanded for the Americans in this game. When Farmer scored the first goal of this game, he had Pauls available but shot himself, and this time the easy pass across. Larocque didn't know whether to stick or twist. Farmer right onto the tape of Pauls' stick. Pauls makes no mistake, and the Americans must feel so comfortable right about now.
Four nothing lead here in the gold medal game. USA out shooting Canada in this period 9-2 and outscoring them 2-0. The long shot is sent into the USA zone. Bridges after it. In to help out is done. Canada did not want to get into this kind of a game, I don't think. They wanted it to be, 1-0, 2-1. And now they got to really work to come from behind. Bridges leaves the puck for Dunn. Banked off the boards, grabbed again by Bridges, and he'll send it in.
So difficult for the Canadians. They've only played two teams in the tournament. They beat the Koreans twice. They lost to the Americans once. Haven't really had a chance to test themselves against anyone quite as good as the USA.
Hickey with a shot that never quite got to the net. Delaney comes in, try to knock it away from Pauls. Bridges was there, and it's scooped up by Brody Roybal. His pass just ahead for Eustace, launches it in off the shoulder of Larocque, and he's going to hold on this time with Malik Jones buzzing in on him. And USA leading this one 4-0 in the second period. They've added two more to their shorthanded goals and the first two even strength goals here in the second period. But it is 4-0 USA in the gold medal game.
Just talking about the fact that Canada maybe they would have really wished in retrospect to have had a game against the Russian Paralympic Committee. They were excluded from the tournament for obvious reasons. And Canada, sort of a middle ground, the RPC would have been between the Korean side that finished fourth and this American team, number one in the world with a bullet. See Farmer, watch him race up the ice. Again, getting the better of Tyrone Henry, the casual pass across in the rock. Well, he had to play the shot because that's what Farmer did in the first rush up the ice in the first period shorthanded. And Pauls on the scene. Didn't score 4 years ago in Pyeongchang, Pauls, but that his third goal of this tournament. Mentioned his nickname is Spuds because his pregame ritual, he points a Mr. Potato Head at the opposing dressing room. Not sure why. Seems to work for him. It's certainly working right now for the Americans in this gold medal game.
Thought someone said his head looked like a potato. I read that somewhere. USA leading Canada 4-0 in the gold medal game. Face off to the left. Dominic Larocque's left as the Canadians get it out to center. And Liam Hickey has to jam on the brakes to wait for the pass. Curls, hooks, holds. Under pressure from Farmer. Dixon comes in to help and got Hickey out of trouble.
Canadians are getting bullied right now. Farmer, I mean, just look at all the speed from, again, a stationary position.
That scramble just outside the blue line now. Hickey picks it up, chips it ahead. Lavin And it'll be McGregor racing after it. Farmer's going to get there at the boat the same time, and he manages to come out with a puck and then loft it out to center. And Liam Hickey spins away from Misevich, dumps the puck into the USA corner. Wallace goes back for it. Under pressure from Westlake. And now Wallace. Farmer taken away by McGregor. It's under the sled and it comes free. We've got a penalty coming here. It's going to be an interference call.
I think it's against Josh Misevich. Shaking his head. I'm not sure he knew where he could go there. Watching the number 24 sweater. Hickey initiated the contact from my money with Misevich. That could almost have gone the other way around.
I'm going to disagree with you on that, because Hickey was trying to line up the puck carrier and Misevich it got in the way of it. So I think that's what happened there.
He's giving you the thumbs up from the American penalty
there
box.
Well, Canada has not had any success in the power play yet.
Quite the opposite.
Yes, a couple of shorthanded goals. Can they do it this time with Bridges, the veteran, all-time leading Paralympic tournament scorer and games played as well. Here's Hickey trying to keep it in at the blue line. It ends up in the Canadian bench. I think Ken Babby, the coach of Canada, would have to think his team has played considerably better in this game than they played in the round robin against the U.S.
I was thinking exactly that, but the problem is that the Americans have upped their game correspondingly as well. They have improved as the tournament has gone on.
And those two mistakes in the opening period on the power play really just kind of sunk Canada at that point. Let's see if they have some kind of a response. You can't score four unless you score one. Here's Bridges at center. Gets across the blue line, but Wallace is there. And he'll chip it back to the Canadian blue line. Farmer, nice play to get free. Left-hand stick, got a pass across for Roybal. And just because the Americans are on the penalty kill doesn't mean they're not dangerous. Here is Liam Hickey, long pass to center, gets it to Dunn. Getting back there is Pauls. Dunn still has it, kind of in his possession. And the Canadians did well to see Dunn, but that speed of Pauls is so hard to battle against. Here's McGregor with some open ice. His shot flipped to the corner. After it goes Hickey. Surveys the scene, takes it in behind the net. Still with the puck is Liam Hickey. And it's going to come out to center. And Farmer puts pressure on Hickey. Gives up the puck to Bridges. Swings it back to Hickey. Now on the left side. Got to the blue line, but now it's sent in. Westlake, stick and puck and all.
Beautifully cleared by Wallace. The Americans never stationary in their own zone on the penalty kill. They managed to keep their momentum, keep their speed up. Makes it so much easier to channel Canadian efforts away from their net.
Bridges to McGregor. Ahead for Delaney. Nice little take on the pass, but couldn't make a play on it. Now Tyler McGregor's pass goes to Dunn. It's out of his reach. He'll try to chase it, but Farmer just so fast comes back, scoops up the puck, and launches it down the ice.
Speed and technique together. That is the American winning combination thus far.
Hickey drops it off to McGregor, swings a pass ahead for Bridges. The power play is over for Canada. Dunn to the red line, and it's sent back into the Canadian zone. Hickey has to hustle, because racing in on it is Travis Dodson in his second Paralympic Games out of New Mexico. McGregor has to work hard in the corner to avoid Malik Jones and banks it on the boards and out to center ice. Jack Wallace, plus 13 is how he entered this game, leading the tournament in plus minus. As the puck is stolen by Delaney from Jones, and we're going to get a hooking penalty here against Wallace when the U.S. touches the puck. But Larocque goes out of his net. He's going to go to the bench, get an extra attacker, and it is Wallace.
Looked like Larocque was steaming up the left wing, pretending he wasn't a goaltender anymore, but you see again the collision. This is the one flaw for the Americans in this game, the number of penalties they have committed already.
I don't know about that one.
Wallace, though, Americans haven't been troubled when shorthanded. opposing teams now 0 for 8 on the power play across the duration of the tournament. And zooming in on the Canadian goaltender at the start of an American power play, what does that say about what we might expect over the next 2 minutes?
Bridges wins the faceoff against Farmer. Back to the blue line for Dixon. Swings it across the ice for McGregor. His shot was high over top of the net. Dixon's going to have to hustle to get in the way of Farmer. He does. And here goes Roybal off to the races. Westlake trying to catch him. He does in this instance. But Roybal still with it. Into open ice for Grove. And a good play by Westlake to block the pass intended for Roybal.
Tried to slip it under the Canadian sled. Roybal was in plenty of open space there, but the Americans couldn't generate the shorthanded chance that time.
Pass finds Dunn. No, it doesn't, because Paul's got in away, and it's going to be a two-man advantage here as USA is getting called for another penalty. It's going to be a teeing call, and it's going to be against Noah Grove. So for a minute 24, Canada will have a two-man advantage. And you be the judge there. Is that the definition of teeing?
It was close, but I would call that a penalty on Grove. And, well, if Canada wants to have any chance in this game, they must score now. I think that goes without saying. 5-on-3, so much open ice. The two-skater advantage for nearly a full minute and a half. This is the moment for Team Canada, surely.
What's interesting is USA has its three fastest players on the ice.
Of course.
And its three best players in Farmer, Pauls, and Roybal. And Roybal gets a hold of a puck and brings it to center and then gets knocked down momentarily by Hickey. So Canada has to start a long way away from the American net. Off of the stick of Dunn, but again, it's Pauls getting back there. And Farmer ahead for Roybal. One thing that's interesting is Roybal, Farmer, and Pauls are all double leg amputees. So they have large, strong upper bodies, but no legs in a sense. And so they're lighter. And every team wants to have those kind of players because it gives them a little bit more speed, possibly, and stamina. And the place battled for in behind the USA net. Couple of Americans there, three Canadians trying to get it out, trying to generate something, but again, it's Farmer who gets it, no Canadian at the blue line, and it's going to go down the ice again.
And they're making this 5-on-3 penalty kill look so easy.
And it's in the final minute, too, of the period, so here's Bridges trying to catch up with it. He does, but it hit him in the sled, and he has to get back out. Here's Hickey trying to get around Josh Pauls. Less than 10 seconds to go in the period. Brody Roybal with the puck. He'll rim it around the boards. One penalty is over. Here's Bridges. Curls with the puck, but no time for a shot because the second period runs out. USA adds two more goals here in the gold medal game. This time they're at even strength, adding to their two shorthanded goals in the second. Jen Lee was strong when he needed to be, and USA leads 4-0 in the gold medal game here in Beijing.
Well, that exclamation mark, the 5-on-3 penalty kill at the end of the period. The Canadians will still have 31 seconds of 5-on-4 time at the start of the third period. But the Americans so impressive in every facet of the game. 4-0 the score. Gold medal surely only 15 minutes away for the USA, trying to win yet another Paralympic gold medal. It would be their fourth in a row and fifth all time. And those fans right now, by far the happier in the National Indoor Stadium in Beijing.
So the team wearing the maple leaf has not had much to celebrate yet in this one. They'll look to regroup in the second intermission. Got outshot 11-2 in that period, outscored 2-0, and trail 4-0 in this gold medal game. And I think lots of Canadian fans would say their team hasn't played badly, just hasn't played well enough. A couple of mistakes by some dynamic players on Team USA who outscore Canada 2-0 in the period, outshooting them by that huge 11-2 margin.
Second period highlights from the National Indoor Stadium in Beijing. Brody Roybal testing Dominic Larocque early. A good confidence-building save for Larocque after he had stopped only one shot of the Americans in the first period. They got two shorthanded goals, of course. There was another effort from Jack Wallace denied by Larocque. And then coming in front of the net, the penalty shot won and then taken by Josh Pauls. But another very good moment in this game for Dominic Larocque, much the busier goaltender in the second period. Finally, he would be beaten by Roybal. Roybal, great pace up the ice to sprint in all alone, beating Larocque. The one assist to Joseph Woodke at the 2:39 mark of the second period. So that made it 3-0. Canadians trying their best. A nice little tip attempt by Liam Hickey, but Jen Lee sprawling along the ice. Then a good blocker save there off of Kyle Zeick's effort by Dominic Larocque. Canadians with chances in the period. Lee there a little bit late to spot the puck, but eventually able to get that mitt firmly along the ice. Americans still buzzing around the Canadian zone. A tough short side chance for Declan Farmer just on the doorstep. No real net to shoot at there. But then the fourth goal of the game easily converted by Pauls, set up by Farmer. That familiar combination working again for Team USA. Time of the goal, 22:51 in the game. And Pauls exultant at giving the Americans the 4-0 advantage. Canada with a late 5-on-3 power play chance in the period. It came to naught. And the Americans dominant against Canada again, 4-0 up with one period left in the gold medal game at the National Indoor Stadium.
It's the Olympic Park in Beijing, China. The scene of the Paralympic Winter Games and the scene of the gold medal para ice hockey game. USA, the three-time defending champions, one period away from making it four, leading 4-0 over Team Canada. An impressive display by Brody Roybal and his teammates. He's got two goals, Declan Farmer and Josh Pauls, each with singles, and they three of them did an incredible job on a penalty kill in the late stages of that second period. Down to a five on, it was a 5-on-3, it's now a 5-on-4. It'll be that way for 31 seconds. But Dominic Larocque's Team Canada will need to dig very, very deep to try to find a way back into this game.
The American trio, the star players, Brody Roybal, 20 minutes on the ice already of the 30 in the game. Josh Pauls, 18 minutes, 16 seconds. And Declan Farmer, 17 minutes, 12 seconds on the ice. We sometimes reference plus-minus statistics. You get a plus one if you're on the ice when your team scores a goal. You got a minus one in that stat if you're on the ice when the other team scores a goal against you. And it's Farmer with plus three, Pauls plus three, Roybal plus three, and Joseph Woodkey plus three. Those are the leading players in that regard for the Americans on the ice in this game. But no surprise that three of those four would be probably the three biggest stars for Team USA. And they got a little bit of luck in the first period. They had one horrendous mistake that they took advantage of from Dominic Larocque in the Canadian goal, who has otherwise played really very well. But once given that little lifeline, the little opening into the game, they know how to prize that door open and keep it wide open for the remainder. And their penalty kill, that's the one thing that David Hoff, the American coach, the math teacher in Bottineau, North Dakota, as his day job, the one thing he would like to see on the ice here is fewer American penalties. Apart from that, it's been a nearly flawless performance, and really does beg the question, is this the best para ice hockey team we've ever seen?
That will be answered very soon. David Hoff trying to become the fourth straight coach, fourth different coach for the U.S. to win Paralympic gold. Billy Bridges, Declan Farmer, some words, probably, I don't mean nasty words, I just mean words, talking before the puck drop to begin the third period. Third period underway in the gold medal game. The team in white, Canada, on the power play. The team in blue, USA, has been dominating when shorthanded in this game. Here's Larocque, gives a pass to Westlake, chips in behind the net for Dixon. Sends a pass up to center ice for Liam Hickey. Following up is Westlake. Hey, right there, ahead for Bridges. Leaning on Farmer, comes out with the puck. Dunn goes after it. It'll be chipped around the boards, and the U.S. has killed off the penalty. Noah Grove is back on the ice. Teams are back to 5-on-5. An incredible penalty kill. Started off the first minute and a half or so in the second period, especially on the 5-on-3 by that trio of Farmer, Roybal, and Pauls.
And a rare American icing with the shorthanded situation having come to an end, but maybe then not quite realizing and playing the puck down the length of the ice. So a Canadian attack zone faceoff draw here. But although Canada clearly the second best team in this tournament and by quite some way, it just seemed that significant bit behind the Americans right now.
Shot on net, steered aside by Jen Lee on the chance from Anton Jacobs-Webb. In fact, that was, yeah, it was Anton Jacobs-Webb, the 21-year-old in his Paralympic debut, battling there, number 26 for Canada, in tight with three Americans all in the vicinity in their own corner. Sent to the blue line, kept in by Dixon. Fires one to the net, and it's just tipped wide by Lavin. And Josh Pauls retrieves the puck, flips it into the middle of the ice. McGregor was there, got it to Jacobs-Webb. And stolen by McGregor. He He's trying to feed it to Jacobs Webb, but the speedy Paul's alert to get back. Wallace over top of the head of the Canadian forechecker. Hickey comes in, throws his shoulder into Farmer. The puck to the blue line for McGregor. And now Farmer reclaims it for USA. We'll dump it in. Gets ridden off by Hickey, but got the job done. Dixon comes back for it. Can't get it out on the first attempt. Gets it to the blue line. Malik Jones stops it. His left-hand shot is fired over the net. Kept in at the other point by Wallace. Now he gets it back again. Here's Jones. Canadians bottle things up in the slot. Hickey gets to it. Chipped it around his man. Got it to the blue line, and it does come out. And Josh Mishevitz brings it right back in again for the Americans. Swings a pass across for Jones. Is for the Colorado Avalanche sled team. Here comes Delaney racing after it, but again, Speedy Paul's getting back to knock it away. And that mad scramble right in front of the penalty box. Hickey got it to Bridges. 37-year-old couldn't get it past number 37. And it's sent all the way down right on Jen Lee. He deals it there for Woodkey. And out it comes to center ice. Armstrong on the ice for Canada, just off the bench. Got it to the American blue line. Stolen, though, by Dunn. He tried to feed it to Delaney. And now Armstrong has to just shoot it into the corner, and the Canadians clear the zone. Pauls has it on his stick. Taken away, though, by Bridges. Nice little curl. He's got time. He hit the goalpost. Another shot from Delaney is stopped by Jen Lee. And Bridges has it back to the blue line for Armstrong. Back to Bridges in the corner. Looks, flips a pass, or at least a shot on net. Maybe looking for a deflection, and it's held by the U.S. keeper, Jen Lee.
Goodness gracious, Billy Bridges. Watch the effort, the puck. First, that the first tip attempt that just skittered wide to the corner, but Bridges getting into a great shooting position. That shot earlier fired over the top of the net, but Bridges hitting the post. Watch him curl between the faceoff rings. Right-handed snapshot. Lee totally beaten. Bridges couldn't beat Lee into the back of the net.
Josh Pauls just smartly sends it to center. Adam Dixon waiting there. He'll dump it in. McGregor races after it, but Roybal beat him to it. And Brody Roybal slides a pass ahead for Farmer. Picked up in the middle by Hickey. Takes it in behind his net. Almost 4 minutes into the third period of this gold medal game. Lavin flips a pass ahead for Dixon, jumping in on the offense. In for Westlake, has to hunt it down in the corner. Hunt, he's being tracked by Broibel, who slams him into the corner boards. I think that play might have started back at center. Here's a shot that's sent wide of the net by McGregor. Lavin goes back for it. Now Dixon to the middle of the ice, but it's waiting there was Pauls. Got it to Zeit, went off his stick. And out it comes to center. Canadians trying to get something going offensively here. Had a little bit of zone time. Had the shot by Bridges, but they better be careful here. Here's Farmer in behind his net. Westlake leans on him. Tries to work the puck to open ice. He gets it ahead for Dixon. And Dixon absorbs a hit and then shovels the puck behind the net. And it's Malik Jones who gets to it. Spins the other way. Gives it to Farmer. Back to Jones. Watched by Dixon. Jones. A centering pass. It's going to deflect out to center. And the Americans back to retrieve with Woodkey. Dumping it into the Canadian corner. Going to come to the net, but Larocq chooses to stay in between the pipes. Probably a wise decision. And it's dug free by Jones. He's had a really good shift here. Now Hickey's going to loft one down the ice. Will it be icing? Yes, against Team Canada with 9:17 to go in the third period of this gold medal game. USA leading 4-0.
Malik Jones, such clever stick handling for the 19-year-old. His first national team tournament for the USA. It's amazing how fluid the American lines are set up. On paper, it's supposed to be Roybal, Jones, and Eustace, the first forward line, Zeich, Farmer, and Misevic, the second line. But any of those six players can be on the ice at any given point in time. It seems David Hoff happy to push the buttons in whatever order he likes, and it always seems to come up exactly as he wants it to.
As long as it's those six players.
Typically speaking, although they do have Travis Dodson, Rico Roman, the two spare forwards, if you will, and they haven't seen much ice time, but they have been out there in some key spots thus far.
If I was coaching USA, I'd make sure that one of the top three are always on the ice at one time. Here's Pauls in for Farmer! Scores! Those two key players strike again for USA. 5-0 here in the gold medal game.
What can you do? Farmer had forever on the doorstep waiting for Larocque to commit. Paul's the defenseman, such a good attacking player as well. Larocque sprawled, but Farmer elevating the puck. Larocque holding, tried his best to not go down, but he just couldn't hang in the air forever. And that the 15th American shot in the game. They've been very efficient, scoring on one third of those 15 shots. And Farmer, well, is he going to set a scoring record that might never be toppled in Paralympic ice hockey, even in just the four games played? What a tournament Declan Farmer is having.
7 goals in the tournament for Declan Farmer, and he's been pouring on all the points.
11 assists as well to go with the 7 goals.
Got one of those today as well. Here's Dunn to the USA blue line. Just a wall of blue, though, stopping the rush, and here they come again. This is going to be Roybal. He's all alone on the breakaway. Roybal, what a save by Larocque this time. He tried to go middle to the outside, but Dominic Larocque shuts the door. But his team needs 5 to draw even. They're down here in the gold medal game.
Good moment for Dominic Larocque. But that look on his face speaks volumes, doesn't it? A little shake of the head that he had to make that sort of save. Misevic away from Henry. Henry maybe hasn't had his best game in a Canadian sweater. So tough to make good decisions against American forwards as pacey as he's encountering here. This is what I was trying to say in terms of Canada not getting to play against the RPC, a sort of intermediate team between the Koreans and the Americans. They maybe could have learned a few lessons from a group stage game against the Russian Paralympic Committee, but boy, the Americans, Farmer, again, here's the goal. Larocque trying to go from right to left. He did get across, but Paul's great vision to spot Farmer for the pass, and Farmer, no mistake, with the finish.
Eight and a half minutes to go, third period. USA leading 5-0 over Canada in the gold medal game, looking to win their 4th straight Paralympic gold medal. Centering pass by Farmer, broken up by Greg Westlake. Now it's onto the stick of Misevic. His pass finds Farmer, and he snaps it wide of the net. Westlake goes back to get it. The other thing, I think, is USA and Canada would have played each other more this year.
Yeah, if there hadn't been COVID situations and games being canceled.
And it could have benefited either team, I suppose. But just playing more games would have helped everyone. Hopefully that will be the case in future years. Liam Hickey comes to center ice, gets to the USA blue line. They know he's a threat, so they gather and defend against him. Here's Malik Jones in his own corner. 19-year-old from Aurora, Colorado. He's been so impressive in this tournament with 4 goals. Here's Lavin for Canada, and here come the Americans with numbers, 4 of them against 1, and that one is Liam Hickey. Here's David Eustace walking in, shooting off the goalpost. And the puck chipped into the corner by Dunn. And he's run over by Roybal, but Dunn recovers to get the puck to the blue line, and Josh Pauls is waiting there. He'll flick it into the Canadian corner. Westlake, or at least Dixon, whacks it off the boards and out to center. David Halls goes back to get it.
Say David Eustace, pointless in the tournament, so close to his first ever Paralympic goal. The 22-year-old from Stoneham, Massachusetts, inches away.
These two teams know each other really well over the years. They played each other a lot. You can just hear some of the conversations, and sometimes there's even a few extra words thrown into the regular conversations. Here's Malik Jones ahead for Wallace. Zach Wallace to center to the Canadian blue line, and coming back hard was Bridges to get a piece of him. Wallace does get a shot, and LaRocque makes a great save, but we're getting a penalty here, and it's going to be against Canada for teeing, and it may be Ben Delaney who's going. Yes.
And that's the first Canadian penalty of the game. Just going back briefly to David Eustace, he actually scored his first career goal for Team USA at the Para Hockey Cup in Paradise, Newfoundland. An example of one of those tournaments we were talking about where players can get much needed international experience independent of the World Championship tournaments or the Paralympics. And Eustace was right there alongside the player coming down the ice there for the Americans. The penalty drawn and another power play this time for the Americans.
Cody Roybal has the puck. He's got two goals in the game already, twisting and turning. Still has it on his right stick, slides it in for Farmer. Wallace surveys the scene, drops it off for Farmer. Takes it into the high slot area. Still has it. Canadians kind of backing up a little bit. Here's Pauls. And he is roughed up and knocked off the puck by Hickey, and he sends it down the ice. Well, you mentioned Newfoundland. Liam Hickey is the pride of Newfoundland. And here comes Brody Roybal, working on the hat trick. He's got two now. Here he comes to center, to the Canadian blue line. Still with the puck. Kind of curl away from Dixon, gives it to Farmer. Takes it in behind the net. Misevich. Centering pass, the puck comes in front, and Misevich picks it up again. Across it goes for Pauls, gives it to Wallace, drills one over top of the net. Misevich now takes a hard hit by Riley. The centering pass goes to Wallace, and LaRocque got enough of it. Here's Roybal. Still more than half a minute to go in this power play. There's a shot. LaRocque makes another save. USA up to 18 shots. Here's Pauls. Here's Misevich. Across the ice, out of the reach of Farmer. And Westlake's going to bat it ahead, but not out. What a great control situation by the U.S. Here's Wallace. Roybal. Wallace. Misevich. Pauls shoots. Blocked by Dixon, throwing his body in front of the puck. Here's Farmer, penalty about to expire, and it's over. So Canada has killed off the penalty, but the time is ticking. And Delaney out of the box, comes up with a puck, gets it to Hickey, but he's got nowhere to go. And now Pauls has it to Farmer. Under 4 minutes remaining in the gold medal game. And it would take a miracle, it would seem here. Here is Westlake. Pass across the ice for Hickey to the USA blue line. Sends a left-handed shot that was steered aside by Jin Lee. I think he touched it. And Hickey and Grove battle, and Grove does a nice job to come out with it, and he'll just slide it out to center ice.
An American power play, everything but scoring. So impressive, always the off-the-puck movement, at least two or three skaters buzzing around, and that hit at center ice by Noah Grove.
Grove and McGregor really ran into each other hard. Chase after the puck in the corner. McGregor to the blue line for Dixon. Slams one towards the net, but it never got there. Hickey has to hustle. He got a piece of Grove, but he got the puck ahead for Woodke. He's got Rico Roman with him, and his shot didn't get a whole lot on it, and it went off the goaltender. USA now up to 20 shots on Dominic LaRocque, who stopped three quarters of them. Here's Eustace. Trying to spin away from Dunn. In just outside of 2.5 minutes to go. And Hickey. Ahead it goes for James Dunn. Brings it to center ice. Pass ahead for McGregor. Sends it into the USA corner.
First shift of the game for D. Quebec there, getting his touch.
Gets it to Pauls. And the USA captain looking to captain his team to a second straight gold medal. Here's Tyrone Henry in his own corner. Banks it for his teammate Anton Jacobs-Webb. Off the boards to the blue line. And now Henry inside of 2 minutes to play in the gold medal game. Pauls does a nice job to get it to the line. Henry does a nice job to keep it in. And it goes into the corner for Malik Jones. In behind for Woodke. Under pressure from Jacobs-Webb. And Woodke got it to Zeich. So a lot of the players on both teams who haven't seen a ton of ice time are out, have been out the last couple of minutes as Henry goes to retrieve at center for Canada.
Yeah, there was a really good chance there set up between Travis Dodson and Rico Roman in the previous American shift. Those two third line forwards in the game combining.
Puck slides in on Jen Lee's net. He gets a big paw on it and will hold on with 1:07 remaining in the third period with a gold medal waiting to be put around the necks of Team USA.
Well, this gold medal game all over, bar the shouting. The Americans, here was David Eustace's effort off the angle of post and crossbar. But the Americans getting some good looks on net from some of their less heralded players. That was Roybal from a sharp angle, again testing Larocque. Really, from top to bottom of this American roster, I mean, they've even got the likes of Evan Nichols, who has only played one game in the tournament. He had 3 assists against the Koreans in the second American Group A matchup. So just goes to show there's plenty more good players in the American system where the 17 involved in this game have come from.
Canadians with an ad hoc line on the ice here with Bridges, McGregor, Westlake, Hickey, and Dixon. All the veterans getting rewarded with maybe the final shift of the tournament. And Farmer is out there with Wallace, Misevich, Roybal, De Quebec, the puck at the side of the net. Mad scramble for it. Canadians would love to break the seal in the USA net if they could, but it is finally dug out, and out it comes to center ice, where Adam Dixon is waiting. His pass to Bridges. Billy Bridges, leaned on by Roybal, leans back on Roybal. And it does come to center ice, and Hickey gets in the way of Misevich. Now inside of 20 seconds away from the Americans' fourth straight Paralympic gold medal. And it might well be an identical 5-0 score that they had in the round robin. Liam Hickey takes it in behind his net. They switched him to defense to try to help, but just did not have enough. And it is USA winning its fourth consecutive Paralympic gold medal. And it's 5-0 the final. The celebrations surround goaltender Jen Lee. And USA reigns again supreme in para ice hockey.
The Americans have worked so hard for so long and are so, so good. They seem to be getting better with each successive year of para ice hockey at international level. You have to feel for the Canadians. They did play much better than they did in the group stage game between these sides, but so did the Americans. They got the early bounces, the two shorthanded goals in the first period, and ever following that, wow, what a performance, what a team in Beijing 2022.
David Hoff, the head coach, becomes the fourth consecutive head coach to take gold for USA at the Paralympic Winter Games. And it'll be silver for Canada. And it will be bronze for Team China on home ice. But Jen Lee, who was the backup the last time and the last two times, now gets the win in the gold medal game. Ken Babby's team just did not quite have enough. Clearly the second best team in the tournament. And USA, clearly the gold medalists, well deserved.
Jen Lee, by the way, he faced 33 shots on goal in the tournament and saved them all. How about that for a starting goaltender performance coming on in place of the great Steve Cash? Griffin Lamar, the backup goaltender for the USA, he conceded the goal that the Koreans scored in the 9-1 defeat by the USA of Korea back in the end of Group A. But man, oh man, from top to bottom, this American roster is so good, so deep, and probably so good going forward.
I think that's really fair, but I also want to say there's three players who stand out above the rest for Team USA. That's Declan Farmer, Brody Roybal, and Josh Pauls. And Canada just could not match that trio. They are so fast, have so much endurance, and it's so hard to defend against them for 45 minutes. And it is Canada in the gold medal game, losing to USA. So USA gold, Canada silver, and China in the bronze medal game over Korea. They take the bronze medal. And there you see the standings. USA, Canada, China, Korea, Italy, Czech Republic, and Slovakia in its first ever Paralympic Winter Games in seventh place. Something to build on. Something special by USA, undefeated in the tournament, only one goal allowed, and they romp again to a gold medal win in the final game.
Both teams getting ready to shake hands with one another or clash sticks in a positive way. This tournament has been played in a very good spirit, and the victory ceremony will be forthcoming in a few minutes' time. We'll have to clear the ice and get the podium set up for the medal ceremony, but you see the Canadians looking a bit glum, the Americans exulting, but good sporting spirits at this para ice hockey tournament in Beijing. Canadians clearly the second best side. Second best, not good enough for anything more than silver against this golden American team.
Nice to see the players who did not play in the game do dress and come out, and they get their medals as well. So both teams, extra players coming out, and they'll be awarded their gold and silver.
Third period highlights from this para ice hockey final. Billy Bridges coming so close to getting Canada on the scoreboard, but the puck wrapping off the pipe behind Jen Lee. That was ultimately as close as Canada would come. Bridges, good shooting position in the slots. And Lee getting down for the second save after he was nearly beaten first time by Bridges. The crunching hit by Roybal everywhere on the ice in this game for the Americans. Malik Jones, a great shift. Look at this great stick handling, far corner, trying to set up a pass. Couldn't quite get the better of Hickey and LaRocque. But eventually, the patient finish, just what you would expect from Declan Farmer. 5 minutes and 57 seconds into the third period. Farmer from Pauls and Roybal, that holy trio, really, for Team USA, coming to the party. Dominic LaRocque, a nice save on the American breakaway chance. David Eustace an opportunity, and he was denied at close quarters by LaRocque. LaRocque ultimately facing 20 American shots, stopping 15 of them. The Americans, another effort there, carried away. Jack Wallace getting the puck on target. LaRocque reaching across to make the stop, and then Roybal, the second effort, another blocker stop by LaRocque. This was the pattern of play in the third period. Roybal up high. Larocq got up to make the stop, but there, the final moments, and Chen Li swarmed by his team. Americans winning this game 5-0 over Canada. Gold certainly deserved by Team USA. So as both teams get ready to clear the ice, the victory ceremony will be forthcoming. Again, USA, Canada, and China, the three medalists in this para ice hockey tournament, believe they will be the final medals to be awarded in this Paralympic Winter Games. So stay tuned. That medal ceremony, the victory ceremony, will be coming up in just a few minutes' time. The victory ceremony for the para ice hockey tournament at Beijing 2022, this concluding event of the Paralympic Winter Games, bar the closing ceremony, which is to come later on at the Bird's Nest Stadium just down the road. And the three flags have been brought into the building by members of the Chinese Armed Forces. And the IPC president, Andrew Parsons, in the building. He will be among those awarding the medals or involved in the presentation. Alongside him, the World Para Ice Hockey Technical Delegate, Mr. Peter Anderson. They are striding out towards center ice. The American and Canadian teams both still in their sleds on the ice. The Chinese team winning bronze, about ready to make their entrance into the National Indoor Stadium in Beijing.
And they had an impressive start to their tournament and real start to their international presence, really. Winning bronze.
Please welcome the medalists.
This will be the biggest noise, probably, of the victory ceremony. The hosts from China being applauded out onto the ice by their home fans on the far side of the building. This National Indoor Stadium, like so many venues, split into separate sections for people inside the bubble for obvious reasons that has been set up for this Olympic Games and Paralympic Games here in Beijing. The Chinese team getting a nice reception as they work their way out to the right side of the ice as we look at it from our near side of the building. That Chinese flag is going to be flying at many other medal presentations in the future, both at Paralympic level and at World Championship level.
Shen Yufeng from Team China, number 17, you'll see him momentarily, was second in tournament scoring with 14 points behind USA's Declan Farmer. What a debut.
You see the two presenters, Andrew Parsons and Peter Anderson. There you see Andrew Parsons will be speaking at the closing ceremony later on today.
He certainly showed his emotion on the in the opening ceremony. Wonder what we'll have to say then.
And Peter Anderson, he has to be so happy the way this sport is developing. The Americans so good, the Canadians really good in second place, and the Chinese emerging in third.
Representing People's Republic of China.
The Chinese team being applauded and applauding the crowd right back. You see the flags waving. The socially distanced crowd, the first medal presented to Wang Wei, their backup goaltender in the tournament. That's Liu Ji in the number 5 sweater by Shui Song. And one goal against Italy in China's 6-0 win. Zhu Jinchang, a very impressive performance in defense. There is Wang getting the flowers as well. On down the line in the number 11 sweater, the sole female participant in the tournament, Yu Jing. Had a couple of shifts in the 6-0 win for China over Italy as well. And Wang Jidong in the number 8, very impressive for China throughout the tournament.
Playmaker right alongside Shen Yufeng, and those two are just a dynamic duo together. Wang Jidong among the tournament leaders in face-offs and in points.
There is Shen Yufeng just receiving his medal after Che Hong and Song Xiaodong. Wang Jucheng, the number 18, then Zhang Zheng, number 19. Gu Guanjian, impressive in defense as well for Team China. And Ji Yan Zhao, the number 20 sweater, their starting goaltender. 11 saves in his shutout of the Koreans in the bronze medal game yesterday.
Not sure if they could have asked for anything better in their home games than to be in a medal game and to win the medal game. They came in with all kinds of speed and talent, even a little bit of swagger. And it was well deserved. And the captain placing the medal on Zhu Xianfu. The captain is Kui Hu Tao.
Had 3 assists against the Czechs in that amazing 4-3 quarterfinal win. Only one of the final 2 minutes of that game, the second goal of it for Wang Jidong. On down the line, Qian Jintao, very good, the number 28 sweater. Chu Jianpeng, number 30. And then Li Hongguan, who scored against the Koreans in the bronze medal game. Team China, very deserving bronze medal winners in their home Paralympic Winter Games.
Indeed, a well-earned bronze medal. Only lost one game in the tournament. It was in the semifinal, and an impressive display by Team China.
Silver medalists representing Canada.
Typically, the silver medalists, the most disappointed players on the ice for a team tournament victory ceremony like this. They were not the victors today. They were outclassed by the best team in the world, Team USA, but nothing to be ashamed of for the Canadians. You see their flags being waved above us. The first player to receive his medal, Rod Crane, who was not in the Canadian side to play today. James Dunn had a hat trick against Korea in the 6-0 win in their second Group A encounter. Tyrone Henry and Rob Armstrong getting their silver medals as well. Zach Lavin in the number 7 sweater. And then the Canadian captain, Tyler McGregor, with 5 goals and 3 assists in the competition.
Yeah, and you can't blame his effort in any way, shape, or form. There are 7 Canadians who are making their debuts at the Paralympic Games, and so they are getting their first ever medals. Rod Crane, Zach Lavin. We'll get it to a couple more.
Dixon's
been around for a while, that's for sure.
Ben Delaney in his 3rd Paralympics, Dixon in his 4th. He led the Canadians in time on ice in the tournament, averaging more than 25 minutes per game. Greg Westlake, number 12. Brandon Sisson, number 15. And then Billy Bridges there, the 6-time Paralympian, had a hat trick against the Koreans in the semifinal win, the 11-0 win 2 days ago.
Yeah, Brandon Sisson getting the flowers now. That's another debutante at the Paralympic Games getting his first ever medal. That's going to be treasured. Billy Bridges has got a drawer full of them.
He does. Garrett Riley, that's his first Paralympic medal. Liam Hickey, what a tournament for him, despite coming out on the wrong end of this contest today. Anton Jacobs-Webb and Antoine Lehoux receiving their medals. And then the 2 goaltenders, Dominic Larocque. He will probably have nightmares about his unfortunate moment in this game, but he played really well apart from that one shorthanded incident. And he was backed up by Adam Kingsmill, who saw action on opening day against the USA and then in the semifinal against Korea.
And it's a really special moment for these players. Maybe they don't feel it right now, but they will appreciate it later as they will treasure all of the medals they're able to win in their career at the Paralympic Winter Games. This one will be silver for Team Canada. Hard fought.
Second place for Canada, but you know where the gold medals are going to in just a moment. By far the standout team in this tournament, the United States of America.
Gold medalists and Paralympic champions representing the United States of America.
获得金牌和残奥冠军的是美国队。 Warm applause, not just from the American supporters, athletes, and fans in the building, but throughout this National Indoor Stadium. Ralph de Quebec, Wreck-It Ralph, getting the first medal. Brody Roybal, how deserving is he of getting gold in this tournament? Jack Walls alongside him. He had a hat trick against the Koreans in the group stage. Travis Dodson receiving his medal. Joseph Woodkey, one of only 4 players to get a point in this gold medal game for the USA, had an assist in the number 11 sweater.
That's his first Paralympic gold.
Absolutely. Kyle Zeik.
Same.
And then, of course, Declan Farmer, likely the MVP of the tournament, the scoring leader with 7 goals and 11 assists. He presented that medal. He'll get his in just a moment.
Yeah, again, the players who are getting it for the first time, it's great for them. And you know what? Their teammates actually really enjoy it. Evan Nichols is getting his first ever Paralympic gold. Malik Jones is getting his first ever Paralympic gold. 19 years of age from Aurora, Colorado.
4 goals in the tournament as well from Malik Jones. Noah Grove, standout in defense. Had a quiet tournament as far as scoring points is concerned, but so solid helping keep the puck away from Chen Li in the American net. You see Rico Roman, real jokester in the locker room for Team USA, a real chemistry player in the squad. Josh Misevich in the number 24 sweater. Boy, he had 4 goals and 6 assists himself, despite being held off the scoreboard today. And then there's the American captain, Josh Pauls. Wow, what a performance for him.
So good, so fast, so patient, so timely in when he jumps in on the rush, helping players like Farmer and the rest jump in on the offense. And Misevich enjoying his, well, second Paralympic gold medal. David Eustis getting his first Paralympic gold medal. You're going to see him in a moment.
It's the backup goaltender Griffin Lamar presenting Pauls with his medal, and then Chen Li will do likewise to his goaltending colleague Lamar from Haverhill, Mass, his first international tournament, and Li his third Paralympic Games for the first time as the number one goalie for Team USA. Rounding things out, David Eustis and Kevin McKee, who did not play in this game, had an assist on opening day against Canada in the group stage. Team USA from 1-2-17 on this roster. What a team, and what a performance from start to finish in Beijing.
Love it how Ralph de Quebec comes around to the other side to help present the medal. And they did do it. Well-earned gold. They were the best team.
Absolutely.
Ladies and gentlemen, the anthem of the United States of America.
女士们、先生们，奏美国国歌。
Spangled banner flying high one last time at Beijing 2022. Confirmation, the medalist in the para ice hockey competition at the National Indoor Stadium. Bronze for China, silver for Canada, and gold for the United States of America.
It's interesting because some teams have really improved on the world level. But it seems like the two top teams have improved even more, and the very top team has improved the most. And where they won in overtime 4 years ago, they win in a 5-0 final for gold here in Beijing.
The Canadians getting ready to leave. The Chinese waving to their fans one final time. You see them beginning to exit off the right side of the ice. And the Americans about to take a lap of honor, as they, fully deserving gold medal winners, coming out to center ice around the blue carpet on the ice surface here. And what a fantastic moment this has been for para ice hockey in Beijing. The Americans golden, Beijing 2022. the victory ceremony now concluded. The United States, their fourth consecutive para ice hockey gold medal. Beijing 2022, another sterling performance for them. Canada taking silver, China getting bronze. Another very good tournament coming to a conclusion at the National Indoor Stadium.
USA's goal scorers in this one, Farmer, Roybal, and Pauls. They led them in the game. They led them in the tournament. They led them to yet another gold medal. In 2010, it was gold over Japan. In 2014, it was gold over the RPC. It was over Canada in Pyeongchang, and again over Canada today. This one may be the most dominating of all as Team USA gathers to celebrate those gold medals around their neck. They take the gold. It's silver for Canada. It is bronze for Team China. Josh Pauls, the captain of this team, enjoying the celebration with his mates. They have everything to celebrate. It is gold for USA in para ice hockey 2022 Beijing. Well done.